Hi folk, today I have here this microphone preamplifier. It comes as a nice kit and costs just 2 euros. Let's look at how good or bad it is. The cables and connectors needed to use it cost many times more. It's sold by a local company, but it's just a generic 2-transistor amplifier, as you can see on this schematic, nothing complicated, and probably will be available with some minor variants from various sources, or you can just get the same components everywhere. The PCB is really simple, and you can build it from the same components even without the PCB, or you can use this picture to copy or even make your own. It will work exactly the same. I will just super quickly assemble it. It's pretty straightforward. Everybody who knows what end of a soldering iron is hot and what end should be held by the hand can easily put it together. I measured the resist to check if I read the color codes correctly, and it looked like their values are within the high spread. But it's not an issue in a circuit like this, and when the final gain is adjustable. I didn't look any closer at those transistors, but it does not have any effect on the sound quality. Even the cheapest Chinese ones will produce exactly the same result as some more expensive ones. It's the schematics itself, and then the power supply and shielding that can affect noise and sound quality. The instructions for this preamplifier, they tell us to use a 12-volt power supply, but you cannot use a modern switched mods power supply because it produces too much noise. You need to have an old school one with a bulky mains transformer. I have here a decent lap power supply, so I will try if it can work on 9-volt, which can be conveniently supplied by a battery. Okay, preamplifier is assembled. Let's try it. I will record it with my USB sound blaster I showed in another video. It will add some noise to the recording. Here is a comparison of recording with and without this preamplifier. Test of Behringer microphone connected directly to sound blaster. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. When I use the microphone preamp, the sound quality improves significantly. Now test Behringer microphone with preamp. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. And here is a comparison of 9 volts and 12 volts. Preamp test on 12 volts. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Preamp test on 9 volts. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. As you can hear, there is no noticeable difference, so you can easily use this preamp with your 9-volt battery. Batteries are a great choice for a preamp because they provide power without any noise. Even the cheapest battery will provide cleaner power than the most expensive power supply, and it will last for a long time in an application like this. As you can hear, the sound quality is decent, especially when we consider the price of this solution. It will be good to place this preamp in some metal case to shield some noise, but it can be in just a cheap plastic box, or just let it without any case if you are brave enough. A common cheap preamplifiers won't be any better until you reach a really high end with prices over 100 euros. So if you can do some basic soldering, I recommend you to use this solution or a similar kit. I hope this info was useful for you. Bye!